Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about the respiratory system. We will be exploring the organs of the respiratory system and their functions. And we will look at the structure and function of the alveolus. Let's study the organs of the respiratory system in greater detail. Firstly, we have the nostril. It allows air to enter the nose. Next, we have the nasal cavity. It contains nose hair to filter the air passing through. The cavity is lined with ciliated cells, which helps to sweep mucus away from the lungs, and goblet cells, which produces mucus. We also have the oral cavity, which allows air to pass through as an alternative route to the nasal cavity. The pharynx allows passage into the trachea and esophagus. Do take note of the next few organs and its location, as they are very important. The larynx contains the voice box. The trachea contains cartilage to prevent the collapse of the trachea. Similar to the nasal cavity, it is lined with ciliated cells and goblet cells. The bronchus, or bronchi, is also lined with ciliated cells and goblet cells. There are different types of bronchi, such as the primary, secondary, and tertiary ones. The bronchus branches out into bronchioles. The bronchiole, or bronchioles, are not lined with ciliated cells or goblet cells. The bronchiole branches out into clusters of alveoli. The alveolus, or alveoli, is the site of gaseous exchange. Before we take a closer look at the structure of the alveolus, let's recap on some of the structures of the respiratory system. From the diagram, you can see how the trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, and alveolus are linked together. As mentioned earlier, there are three types of bronchi, and in this diagram you can see the primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, and tertiary bronchi. Now, let's zoom in on the structures of the alveolus, the site of gaseous exchange. Firstly, the alveolus has a large surface area to volume ratio. The large number of alveoli increases the surface area to volume ratio, thereby increasing the rate of diffusion of gases. Secondly, the alveolus is small and elastic. The elasticity enables the alveolus to recoil after it is fully filled or expands with air. This allows the removal of the previous batch of air, allowing a fresh batch of air to enter. Thirdly, the alveolus is one cell thick. This reduces the distance required for the diffusion of gases. Fourthly, the alveolus has a thin layer of moisture. This allows oxygen to dissolve in it, which speeds up the rate of diffusion of oxygen. Lastly, there is a dense network of capillary surrounding the alveoli. This enables blood to flow through the alveoli continuously, which allows the maintenance of the oxygen concentration between the air and the bloodstream. That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.